This tutorial will show you how to add AR occlusion feature for your easy AR scene. When this AR occlusion feature is added, virtual AR objects can be covered by objects that are physically present in front of it within a room.
Hi, I'm Shanara Pires, customer educator at Render Island by Liveroom. So let's get started.
First, I will take our AR single object scene from the Easy AR Scenes folder. Find the AR single object and double click on it. Go to AR camera and add AR occlusion controller script over here, and it will automatically add the AR occlusion manager script as well. By default, environmental depth mode will be disabled, and you can select one of the modes as you prefer. You have to also place two references in the AR Occlusion Quality Controller script, which I will create now. For that, I will create a new canvas by right-clicking on the hierarchy panel and going to UI and then clicking Canvas. I will then add a warning panel to the canvas by right-clicking the canvas and clicking UI and then clicking on Panel. I will also add a quality control panel by searching for it here. It can be found in the Easy AR prefabs folder. I will drag and drop it over our canvas as a child of our canvas, which can be seen on the scene window. You can now select the quality level from it. I will disable this quality panel and move on to creating the warning panel, which is responsible for giving warning messages if the device does not support depth API. I resize it and move it to the middle of our window first by pressing the Alt key and clicking middle. For now, I will turn off my AR scene handler and go to our warning panel and rename it as warning panel. For the background of the warning panel, I will search for the warning panel sprite and drag and drop it over the source image. I then set it to the native size and resize it by pressing Shift and dragging it above a bit. I have to add an image and some text to the warning panel by right-clicking on the warning panel and going to UI and selecting Image. I will then set it to the left side corner of our window and offset it a little. I will then add the warning icon image to the source image. To also add some text to it, I will right click on the warning panel, click UI and select text. I will resize it by clicking the resize icon and dragging it to my preferred size. I will then increase the font size, set the alignment to the center, and change the font color to white. I will now edit the text to what I want the panel to say. Our warning panel is then ready to use. You can then go to AR camera and add our quality panel over here and our warning panel over here. I now want to add a button to open our AR Occlusion Quality Control panel. So I right click on Canvas, click UI and select Button. I then change the position of the button to the right top corner and change the width and height of the button and position it where I want to. I delete the text in this button and rename it to Occlusion Quality Control button. I will then change the sprite to the I button over here and add a click event for the button by clicking this plus button. You can then drag and drop AR camera over here. You then change the function to AR Occlusion Quality Controller and click Show Quality Control. Click this checkbox, which is responsible for the AR Occlusion Quality Controller to be shown once the button is clicked. I will now open our Occlusion Quality Controller button and disable it, and then go to the Quality panel and enable it. You have to go to each of these buttons one by one and set each function from the AR camera controller and select Change Quality to Fastest. You do the same for the medium one and you select Change Quality to Medium. You have to repeat it in the same way for the best and no occlusion options as seen here. You then go to the Quality Control panel and Warning panel and disable them. Double check the panels under the AR Occlusion Quality Controller script. You can then save it. Make sure that your AR Scene Handler and Occlusion Quality Control button have been enabled. You can check if it is functioning properly by clicking the Play button above. You can click the I button and it will show that the device is not supported as you are currently in editor mode. That's how you add our new feature AR Occlusion to your Easy AR scene. You can build your Easy AR app by going to File, Build Settings and then building it.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.